Most of the engine oil manufacturers offer race-derived engine oils as their flagship. And to be honest, my experience has been really good with them. In fact, these race-termed engine oils have busted some serious myths in the lab test as well. Shell did something different by formulating the Shell Advance Long Ride Engine Oil. I'm confident that a lot of you guys didn't come across this engine oil, and it's expected, because as of now you won't find it on Amazon or Flipkart or even on Shell India's official website. No, it's not a fan-made product as it's retailing through Shell fuel stations, so we can trust the authenticity of this product. In fact, I got quite a few messages from Malaysian riders where this engine oil was launched last year, and recently from a few Indian riders as well regarding this same engine oil. The Dominar demands a 10W50 grade synthetic engine oil, and after a long wait we get this from Shell, which is said to have a different formulation. The Dominar's engine performed well on this engine oil, but if you are a city rider, then you must know that the Dominar doesn't really like traffic riding as much as it loves open roads. My personal experience with this engine oil was not so good in heavy traffic, which demands frequent gear shifts in stop and go stressed conditions. However, with the Shell Advance Long Ride, the fuel efficiency always remained over 30 km per liter even inside the city, which is good for an engine of this size. Last week I was stuck in the slow moving low gear traffic for almost an hour and a half, still the motorcycle returned 32 km per liter with no overheating issues. This also brings me to the engine oil temperature, which was around 68 degrees Celsius after doing a 100 km non-stop highway ride, which is okay for a liquid cooled engine. Open highways is where both the Dominar and the Shell Advance Long Ride feel at home. The viscosity index of 160 helped the engine in performing well even when I was holding triple digit speeds for long. If you ask me, then as per my experience, the Liqui-Moly Street Race and the 300 V-Square gave a better gear shift experience than this. But Shell has formulated this engine oil with kinematic viscosity on the higher side when compared to the other mentioned engine oils. But surprisingly, it didn't create much resistance in either performance or efficiency. All of this should help in meeting the claims of long ride with longer drain interval. And I liked the fact that Shell is transparent and reasonable with its claim of 6000 km of protection, where I'm expecting around 3500 to 4000 km of service life in a liquid cooled motorcycle like this under heavy riding conditions. At the end of the day, it's always good to have that missing 10W50 grade engine oil from Shell's offering, which has taken a different approach this time. This brings me to the end of this video, but my search for this kind of hidden options for you guys will still continue on this channel. So that's all for this video, and I hope you guys have liked it.